limit effects based on how fast or slow something moves to particular regions of your shot. With Boris Effects Continuum's 2025 maintenance release, we've added additional features in Motion Blur ML, including a speed map. Let's use this to drive other effects inside of Boris Effects Suite for the ultimate new effects workflow. Okay, I'm here inside of Premiere Pro and I have a time-lapse shot. If we take a look at this full frame, we can see that the subject in the center doesn't move a lot. We've got a bunch of subjects in the back who move very fast and have a trails as well as motion blur effect, as well as some subtle camera movement with a zoom. What we'd like to do is exaggerate that trail movement. And one way we can do that is actually with Boris Effects Sapphire. There's an S_trails effect. I'm gonna select it, which happens to be in the Sapphire time category and available to me because I've already done a search. What you can notice is that there's now additional ghosting on our subjects, but it also affects the luminant areas in our shot within the chalkboard and some areas in the foreground. To see this, I'm gonna scroll down so we can see the effect on the clip under effect controls, just turning it off and on. Instead of this, we'd like to limit the S trails effect to the fastest sections of our clip. Now, let's see how we can do that by first of all, removing S_trails from our clip, and we're gonna duplicate it. So I'm gonna Option click and drag to make a copy, lower the height of my V1 track, and temporarily turn off V2. On the V1 clip, we're gonna do a search for Motion Blur ML. Recently, in the Continuum 2025 maintenance, once I apply this to the clip, we can first of all see the motion blur, but they've added an additional output. And this allows us to visualize the fastest moving parts in our shot. I'll change the output to speed map. And right now you can see that the fastest moving subjects happen to be identified by white. Things that aren't as fast are identified by different levels of gray. And things not moving at all, you may be able to make out the vignette of the subject in the center here, are gonna be pure black. Another great tool in Motion Blur ML is to take the compare mode, just turn it on to side by side. It's available in all BCC Plus effects, and we can compare that speed map to our original clip. I'll turn off compare mode, and we're gonna take the clip on V1 and then just nest it. I'll call it speed map, and we're gonna use this mat to drive that S-trails effect using an in-between effect called Pixel Chooser. So I'm gonna turn on now my clip on V2. What we're gonna do is a search for a pixel chooser. We've recently updated this masking and tracking effect to BCC Plus. I'll add it to the clip and it automatically turns black for the reason that in Pixel Chooser, the output is set to view a black and white mat. So we can keep track of what we're doing. We're gonna set this to alpha channel and we'll start to see the brightest areas of the speed map seep through this. I'm gonna just turn that off so we don't get confused. And what we'll use to drive the alpha channel of this clip will be under Pixel Chooser. So let's head to the matte section, which is currently set to the Luma channel. And by default, because we haven't specified a matte layer, it's using itself as that matte. Instead, let's reference the speed map on the video track 1. And immediately we'll now see that that white information carries over, identifying the fastest moving parts of your shot. And with this limit, we can now have S-trail in those regions only. Before we do that, we can actually clamp this effect further using a few of the values underneath the matte type of levels. Pre-smooth out this effect. We could also increase the black level in order to get rid of areas that aren't as fast moving. And then decrease the white level to increase the intensity of areas that are fast moving. Now that we've set up Pixel Chooser, I'm gonna just close this out. And we're gonna duplicate the clip in our project one more time. So I'm gonna Option click and drag to create another time-lapse trail effect. On the V3 track, I'm gonna keep Pixel Chooser, but on V2, I'm gonna get rid of it entirely. Now, on the V3 clip, let's do a search for our S-trails effect, S_trails. We'll now apply that to the V3 track. And notice that our trails are now limited to just those fast-moving regions. We can turn off our V2 track just once again in order to see how it is affecting our clip and make additional changes to the values in order to perfect our trails. So I'm going to increase the max steps here to get a few more trails. I'll also change the combination to screen just to brighten the trails overall, but change the previous brightness, lowering that a bit to make the overall effect a little bit less intense. Last but not least, I'll adjust the hue shift, the previous hue shift by a little bit in order to have a bit of color differentiation between our trails and the original shot. Let's take a look at the final effect. I'm only just touching the surface of what's possible by referencing speed maps using Boris Effects Suite and limiting effects to the movement of objects within your frame. For more tips and tricks like this, don't forget to subscribe and check us out at borisfx.com.